Hey, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Alexander, and I'm a guitarist, composer, and overall music nerd from Copenhagen, Denmark. And in this video, we're going to check out my top 5 exercises to help you break out of intermediency and join the pro guitar range with the gods. But in all seriousness, these exercises actually helped me out quite a lot, stitching some of the more advanced techniques together and learn to play more fluently, especially when soloing and stuff like that. So of course, hope that you enjoyed. So we've all been there, right? Practicing seemingly pointless exercises for weeks and weeks on end with the promise that it will make us better guitar players. Yes, I'm looking at you for an open string chromatic warm-up exercise. And also you too, an open string pentatonic scale exercise. The big problem that I have with exercises like this is it has nothing to do with actual music. They simply do not train the things that you encounter out in the real world when you're playing other people's songs or you're writing your own material. Personally, over the years, I progressed a lot more as a guitar player by picking up other people's songs that are way over my level and simply tried to survive and drill it until I really nailed it. So after a little while, or maybe actually a bunch of years, I started to create exercises that drilled the specific things that I figured out I couldn't do in the specific context that I couldn't do them. And as it turned out, most of the time the problem stemmed from not being able to switch between different techniques fluently, especially at higher speeds. With all of that being said, of course, the traditional exercises are good for something, or else people wouldn't do them or come up with them. That would just be mean. They're of course great for beginners or if you're just starting out picking up a specific technique. But to really take the next step and really improve and become fluent in the language of guitar or the language of this specific technique, they're really not good anymore. Which leads us to this week's topic. I have put together 5 of my personal favorite mixed technique exercises, and I'll of course be going through the ins and outs of these exercises with you in this video. So if you can do this, and maybe this, a little bit of this, and of course this, then this video is for you, so stay tuned. Alright guys, so the time has come. As with every YouTube video, feel free to subscribe to the channel, like the video, say hi to me down in the comments, or maybe share the video with a friend who would also benefit from watching this video. Also, if you by any chance are scrolling down to check out the comments or the description, there's a bunch of cool links down there that will help support me and support the channel. For example, you could head to my website composition101.com where I offer a really cheap and really awesome subscription service. Here you get access to all of the material for my YouTube videos, also the tabs, exercise videos, and stuff like that for this specific video. And of course, all of my courses, all of my lesson libraries, and all of that good stuff is available there. All right, with all of that out of the way, let's head into the first exercise. So in exercise number 1, we start out with an ascending 6-note run using legato. We then move into a descending 6-note shape run with alternate picking. We go into an A minor arpeggio using sweep picking, and then we shortly slide into a G major, or we could also see it as E minor 7 arpeggio, also utilizing sweep picking. So this particular exercise is really great for mixing up legato and alternate picking. Try to aim for getting a fluent transition between the two techniques. Of course, they have their different qualities in sound and we cannot do anything about that, but we don't want a sort of glitch in between where you switch between legato and alternate picking. And then of course, we have these two sweep picking arpeggios in the end, and it's a bit more of an advanced technique and you probably have to switch up your picking hand just a little bit in order to get into the right motions, and that is what this exercise also targets. So let's have a listen to exercise number 2. So here we start out with an ascending alternate picking sequence into a descending G major 7 sweep picking arpeggio, directly into ascending D minor 7 sweep picking arpeggio. Then we get this big slide, which leads us into a descending A minor sweep picking arpeggio, and we end out with this B diminished sequence that is played with economy picking. Alright, so this exercise really targets the transition between different techniques. So first between alternate picking and sweep picking, which can be really tough depending on you ending on a down or an upstroke or what direction the sweep is actually going. And then of course there's a bunch of sweep picking in a row where we switch between different shapes, and of course you should aim for these being as clean as possible, so no strings ringing together, only one string ringing at a time, and have really clear articulate notes. Alrighty, let's take a look at example number 3. So in example number three, we start out with a three note per string pattern using tapping, and we end out with a little slide with the tapping finger as well. Then we have a descending line, first with two note per string, and then two strings with one note per string. And then we go into an ascending legato pattern that, luckily for us, uses the same three note per string shape all the way to the end. So in this particular exercise, we step up the difficulty just a little bit because we start to utilize tapping and string skipping all in one exercise. And that can of course be really tough, but this is a great time to start learning that. Then in the middle, we have this little descending run where we switch between having two notes per string and one note per string. And that can of course be really tough on the right hand, our sort of perception of the line that we're playing. Then luckily in the end, we catch a little break with this little ascending legato run using the same shape. If you're enjoying this lesson and maybe want a bit more in-depth information on some of this stuff, technique videos, the tabs for this particular lesson, or something different, please consider heading to the link down in the description and you can find it all on my subscription service. All right, let's move on to exercise number four. So in exercise four, we start with an ascending three note per string legato pattern going directly into an alternate picked little sequence. Then we have a descending B diminished arpeggio going into an A minor arpeggio, which is debatable whether it's sweep picking or economy picking, but you can kind of do both, of course, and they're sort of related. Then we go into an ascending three note per string pattern using tapping. And of course, we could see this as C major going into B diminished. And then we end on this two note per string with hammer on from nowhere in the end. Ooh, okay, this exercise is quite a killer and it's a little bit difficult to get down. And it's of course because it mixes a lot of the more advanced techniques that there are. And it's not just ascending and descending in six note shapes and these standard sort of arpeggio shapes. So if you're really looking for an all-in-one exercise that really trains fluidity and transition between techniques, this may be the exercise for you. So a little side note for an exercise like this, when the complexity level of an exercise like this is so high, it's not necessary to push for speed, or it is not at least the goal, not for me. It's to get the fluidity between the different techniques and the transitions between the techniques perfect and being able to execute all of the techniques with the correct pick attack or the correct attack or clarity out of the notes and not necessarily going a million miles an hour. All right, so let's check out the fifth and final exercise. So for exercise 5, first you'll notice it's all in 6 tuplets. Then we start out with these two sequences that are built on 2-1-2 shapes, both in the sort of first position of natural minor, in this case A natural minor. Then we have a descending A minor sweep picking arpeggio going into a diminished 7 sweep picking arpeggio, ascending legato 6 note shape, and then in the very end we get into this descending double picked diminished shape, that is quite a word, which is of course sequenced all the way down the neck, so it's easy to loop the exercise. So this exercise is really cool in my opinion. It utilizes some of my favorite not only techniques but also concepts, among others the 2-1-2 shapes, which are really great for creating a bit out of the box sounding arpeggio shapes. And then we of course get a bunch of diminished shapes, both in arpeggio or sweep picking arpeggio form, but also in this sequenced form, which are always cool. And then by the very end, we get this really cool double picked diminished shape, which is really, really cool to cover some ground on the fretboard. And in this case, being able to loop the exercise a little easier. So like all of the other exercises, the exercise really trains the transition between these different techniques. And in this case, with a bit of a better jump sometimes and some string skipping and stuff like that to really challenge you. All right. That is all of my 5 exercises, and I of course hope that you enjoyed them. As I mentioned before, if you want the tabs or the guitar profiles, some more in-depth lessons on all of these techniques or this particular mixed technique concept, feel free to head down to the link in the description and check out my subscription service. It is all available there. All right, so we've reached the end of the video, guys. Thank you very much for taking the time out of your day to watch it. I of course hope that you enjoyed the exercises and you got some inspiration and some motivation to sit down and practice. In case you didn't already, consider to subscribe to the channel, like the video, say hi to me down in the comments, or maybe share the video with a friend who would also benefit from it. All right, so that is all for this week's video. Again, thank you very much for taking the time to watch it. Stay safe out there and healthy. Until next time.